We want to multiply the given rational expressions, but before we multiply, we do want to simplify out all the common factors between the numerators and denominators that we simplified at 1. And to do this, we have to factor everything first. We cannot simplify across addition or subtraction, meaning we cannot simplify, for example, this 4x squared and this 4x squared because of the subtraction, connecting it to additional terms. So again, the first step is always to factor all of the numerators and denominators. So to factor 4x squared minus 4x minus 3, notice how there are no common factors. So if this does factor, it'll factor into two binomial factors, where the first terms of the factors must come from 4x squared. Let's try 2x and 2x. And the second terms in the binomial factors must come from the factors of negative 3, so that the sum of the inner product and outer product is equal to negative 4x. So let's try minus 3 here and plus 1 here. Luckily, there aren't very many factors of negative 3. Notice our inner product is negative 6x, the outer product is positive 2x, which does have a sum of negative 4x. So that's factored correctly. To factor 6x minus 9, the greatest common factor would be 3, so we'll factor 3 out, leaving us with the quantity 2x minus 3. For 3x squared plus 12x, notice both terms have a factor of 3 as well as a factor of x. So the greatest common factor is 3x, leaving us with the quantity x plus 4. Then for 4x squared minus 8x, the greatest common factor would be 4x. So we'll factor out 4x, leaving us with the quantity x minus 2. Now that everything is factored, we can now simplify. So here we have a factor of x minus 3 over x minus 3. That would simplify to 1. Here we have 3 over 3. That would simplify to 1. And we also have x over x. That would simplify to 1. So now we can multiply, knowing our product will be in simplest form. The numerator will consist of a factor of 2x plus 1 and a factor of x plus 4. The denominator will contain a factor of 4 and a factor of x minus 2. And now we have our product in simplified form. Let's go and take a look at our second example. Again, before trying to simplify, we want to factor everything. X squared minus 1 is a difference of squares. This will factor into the quantity x plus 1 times the quantity x minus 1. Now 2 minus 3x does not simplify. But notice how we always have the x terms first, so let's change the order of this factor. Let's write this as negative 3x plus 2. Notice how the 2 is still positive and the 3x is still negative. To factor 9x minus 6, we'll factor out 3, leaving us with the quantity 3x minus 2. And then for 5x squared minus 8x plus 3, again, we're hoping this will factor into two binomial factors. The first terms must come from the factors of 5x squared. Let's use 5x and x. The second terms must be the factors of positive 3. Again, so the sum of the inner product and outer product is going to be negative 8x. So we'll have to use the negative factors of 3. If we put minus 3 here and minus 1 here, notice how we have negative 5x and negative 3x, which does give a sum of negative 8x. Now before we start to simplify, let's take a look at these two factors here. Here we have a factor of 3x minus 2. Here we have a factor of negative 3x plus 2. Notice how the terms are opposite signs. So what that means is, if we factor out a negative or a negative 1, it would change the sign of these factors and then simplify with the 3x minus 2. So let's go ahead and do that. Again, everything else is the same except now here we're going to factor out a negative, which is going to change the sign of these two terms. We'll have a positive 3x and then a minus 2. Notice when we do this, here we have a factor of 3x minus 2 over a factor of 3x minus 2, which simplifies to 1. And here we have a common factor of x minus 1 over x minus 1. Looks like nothing else is going to simplify. So in the numerator, notice how we have a factor of x plus 1 and a factor of 3. That'll be 3 times the quantity x plus 1. In the denominator, we have this negative sign, and we also have a factor of 5x minus 3. There's a couple ways of handling this negative sign. We could move it up into the numerator like this, or if we wanted to, we could just move the negative out in front. Either way is acceptable. Normally you won't see it left in the denominator, even though it could be. Okay, I hope you found these examples helpful.